Hello, YouTube friends. This is Ruben from Hi-Fi MIDI, and I want to wish you a happy new year. I hope your vacation was great. Mine definitely was. I was able to make more videos, and I hope I can continue to do more so this year. Now, over the break, a few of you requested that I make a video on how to play guitar on keyboard. I know this is something very difficult to do because a guitar is obviously a string instrument, and a keyboard is technically a percussion instrument, so it's hard to get those same nuances. But technology has gotten a lot better, and I hope that I can give you some good tips on how to take advantage of those developments. So I'm going to start off with this Taylor 914 CE plugin from Ample Guitar. This plugin is one of my favorite. It's not that expensive. It's about $160. I think it's on sale right now, but I'd have to confirm that. And I'm going to start off with finger picking. One of the first tips I'd give when you're finger picking, if you want a realistic sound, is to keep it at six fingers or less. Now, you can go into keyboard mode and play like a keyboard, so you can play all the notes that you want. That's fine if you're going to just be using the sound of a guitar and not really care about how real it sounds. But I don't like playing like that. I like making it sound realistic. So I like to keep it at six fingers or less. I'll give you an example of this. I'm going to play in the key of E major. Oops, let me play a little lower. One, two, three, four, five, six. So always keep it at six or less. In the left hand, I like to just play the first note and the fifth and the octave. And then I will add the third on the right hand and then the fifth. And then the first. What makes it sound realistic also is adding neighboring or passing tones. Now, when you're going to strum like this while you're finger picking, it's good not to press all the notes at the same time. That's just not realistic. When you're playing guitar, because you're going one direction or the other, there tends to be the notes that you're starting off with, of course, are going to be played before the last notes. So there's this rolling effect. So let's try the finger picking mixed with the strumming. And that just makes it a little more realistic. Now, when you're playing that over other instruments, particularly this plugin, you're not going to be able to tell that it's going to be a lot harder to tell that it's a plugin, because all the perfections, not imperfections, all the perfections of this, of the recording, the sample are going to be covered by the instruments. Let's try it in a different key to see how it sounds. Now, as you continue to play or use this plugin, or other plugins that have a similar type of engine in them that won't allow you to play something impossible in its normal mode. For example, this. Well, I guess it does let you, never mind. So next, I want to get into strum mode, and now obviously you're limited on what you can do in strum mode. Here in this section, you can have preset patterns assigned to certain keys of your choice. I do not like using this. I mean, it's fine if you're one of those type of people that likes to program, but I like playing things myself. For example, this can respond to your touch, to the velocity. It's like a real guitar, if you press it softly, it's going to do a few keys. If you strum it hard, it's going to do a lot of them. When you strum, you're going to want to mix the muting or the stopping with the strumming. Over here we have our preset keys, which for this example I'm only going to use C major, F major, and G major, and A minor. But do you hear that little squeak right there, the fret slide? Now, what you want to do is avoid, when you switch from chord to chord, you want to avoid pressing the chord at the same time as you strum. You're gonna wanna do it just a little bit in advance. I'll show you how. I'll show you first doing it at the same time. That sounds okay, but to get a more realistic sound and to make sure that the engine or the plugin actually changes the chord in time, you'll want to do that switch just a half second earlier. Then you get that fret slide that's realistic with guitars. And there's that fraction of a second delay actually strumming the chord, which is how guitars actually play. Let's hear how it sounds in the context of a band. Now for this, I am cutting out a lot of the lows to give room for the bass. Kind of brighten up the sound, or actually make it less thick. So here we go. Pretty cool. Oh, I muted that channel. I forgot to record it. Because there's something else I wanted to show. All right, let's start right here. What am I doing? Okay, so let's hear how that sounded, and let's look at the piano roll. So we had that little mistake right there. I'll ignore it for right now. It's not what I want to focus on. What I want to focus on is this pattern right here. Sorry about that hideous sound. Now I'm going to quantize this part by itself. And it's at 16th notes. All right, so what would happen is that it's going to get close to the closest quarter note or 16th note. And what that's going to do is I think it's going to give it a delayed kind of sound. So you're going to hear the strum a fraction of a second or a beat later than it should be. So I've made the strumming a lot straighter, a lot more more in time, but at the same time, I've caused it to be delayed. And the way we fix that is by highlighting only this data right here. Zooming in on the track. It could be anywhere, actually. And then dragging everything slightly to the left. Let's hear how that sounds. Very cool. Now, if you want to see closely how I did that strumming pattern, so here it's strumming up. Just play with the sounds. I like to alternate between down and up strum, just like a real guitarist. And the cool thing about this plugin is that you can actually control the strum time. I actually never have it this slow, but I mean, it sounds better around 30, 35. If I'm going to be doing something slow, I might as well just use the picking. Oops. So I hope those two tips helped you, or those few tips helped you. Some of these techniques can be applied to other guitar plugins. This is the only good acoustic guitar plugin that I have. All that and Ample Guitar's AGM, which is a Martin M15. But I hope this was helpful. Send me requests for more types of videos and I'll see if I can do them. I love helping you guys. I'm learning this stuff myself. So I hope you have a great year and I'll see you next time.